Welcome, my dear learners, for this course on Engineering Graphics. So far, we have discussed different varieties of problem on orthographic projection of solids in our module 3. Let us move on for the final topic, that is freely suspended solids. Let us solve a problem on freely suspended prism. Our problem number 19 states that a pentagonal prism of 25 mm sides of base and 50 mm axis length is suspended freely from one of its corners. Draw the projection of the prism when the axis appears to be inclined at 45 degrees to VP. In the first position, we'll make this solid stand on horizontal plane without inclining to any of the planes. Therefore, in the top view, I can see the pentagon. In the front view, the prism looks like a rectangle. Now, in the second position, we will suspend this solid from one of the corners. It is not specifying whether we should suspend the solid with base corner or from the apex corner. If nothing is clearly specified for problems on prisms, you always go for apex corner, that is the corner, one of the corner from the top face. Then in the final or third position, show the remaining inclination. The remaining inclination is with respect to vertical plane. He is clearly stating that the axis appears to be inclined at an angle of 45 degree to vertical plane. So therefore, what he is mentioning is the apparent angle of inclination, that is beta angle for this problem. So therefore, the solution for this problem is, in the first position, prism stands on HP. In the second position, prism is freely suspended from one of its corners. And in the third and final position, I should show the inclination with respect to vertical plane. Is clearly stating axis appears to be inclined at an angle of 45 degree to VP. Let me draw the XY line first. This is vertical plane and this is horizontal plane. Since it is a pentagonal prism, draw a pentagon in HP such that I will get corner towards my right hand side. This is because of the reason we are suspending the prism from one of its corners. So therefore, draw a pentagon such that you will get corners towards right hand side. So if I do that, first you draw the reference line, which is nothing but the edge of this pentagon. The base side length is 25 millimeters, so therefore draw a 25 mm line. Now on the either corners of this edge, you mark 72 degrees exterior angle. Marking 72 degrees exterior angle, draw the edge inclined at an angle of 108 degrees from interior, whose dimension is 25 millimeters. Now, using compass, cut arcs from these two corners, measuring 25 mm length. Measure 25 mm, cut an arc with the same dimension from this corner, intersect this arc. Now, joining these two corners, I'll get the required pentagon, in which I am getting corner towards my right hand side. So this completes the required pentagon. If I mark the corners, since this is a prism, I will be having A at the top, A1 at the bottom, B at the top, B1 at the bottom, C at the top, C1 at the bottom, D at the top, D1 at the bottom, and finally E at the top, E1 at the bottom. Now find the center of this prism. You have to find the center of this prism, draw a perpendicular bisector from any two corners to the opposite edge. Now for this corner D, the opposite edge is AB. Draw a very thin line, because This line is just for the reference to identify the center of this pentagon. So at the center we have axis O at the top, O1 at the bottom. Don't join dark lines from any of the corners. Be careful, we are solving prism. Now take the projection vertically upwards and mark the axis. In case of prism, the longer edges are parallel to the axis itself. So therefore, take the projection and marking the longer edges and axis to the dimension equal to the axis, which is nothing but 50 millimeters. If I do that, I'll get, this completes the front view after taking the projection vertically upwards and marking the longer edges and axis. In the front view, observer will be here. To the observer, the corners B, C and D are visible, whereas the corners A and E are invisible. So therefore, at the base we have B1 prime, whereas A1 prime is invisible. C1 prime, whereas E1 prime is invisible. Coming for this corner, we have D1 prime and D prime. At the top face, we have C prime, E prime, which is invisible. We have B prime, A prime, which is invisible. Now, coming for the axis, we have O1 prime. In the front view, axis is always invisible, and at the top face, we have O prime. In the front view, all these alphabets have superscript prime to differentiate that they are representing the front view. Now, show the dimension both in the front view and also in the top view. If I do that, the base length is 25 mm, whereas the axis is 50 mm. Now, very important thing to be noted down for a freely suspended problem is that from any of the corner, you join the center of gravity of this solid. So for this solid in the front view, we are having the rectangle. The CG of the rectangle is at a distance of 1 by 2 from the base on the axis of this solid. So therefore, measuring half of the dimension and marking the CG for this solid. So mark 25 mm from the base and identify the CG for this solid. So I'll get center of gravity. So now he is asking us to make it freely suspended from one of the corner. I can join this base corner to CG and make it freely suspended, or I can join the top corner to CG and make it freely suspended. Unless otherwise specified, always go for top corner so that the problem will become easier to solve. So therefore, going for the corner from the top face, join D prime to CG with a very thin line. This is for our reference. So now, for a freely suspension problems, this line which we have used, that is D prime to CG, should be vertical or perpendicular to horizontal plane. And one more very important thing for freely suspended problems, none of the corners or edge must touch the HP. Be careful, draw such a way that none of these corners or edges should touch the horizontal plane. So therefore, take suitable height away from the horizontal plane and mark D prime, draw D prime to CG vertical. So using this line, reconstruct the entire prism. If I do that, first let us make this D prime CG vertical. Measure the length D prime to CG. Draw a vertical line. So thereby I have transferred D prime and CG. Now based on this line D prime CG, you completely reconstruct this prism and take care that none of these edges or corners of the base should touch HP. So therefore, use compass and measure D prime to B prime draw an arc. From CG, you measure the same edge, intersect that arc. Measuring D prime to B prime, I'm drawing an arc. From CG, I'm measuring the distance of the same edge, B prime, A prime, and I'm intersecting the arc. So thereby, I have transferred B prime, A prime. Now, join D prime to B prime, A prime. If you clearly observe, B1 prime to B prime is perpendicular to D prime to A prime. Similarly, B1 prime to D prime is perpendicular to A1 prime to A prime. So therefore, draw the perpendicular lines whose dimension is 50 mm at the corners D prime and B prime. So drawing the perpendicular lines whose dimension is 50 mm, finally you join the base. Thereby we have transferred B1 prime, A1 prime and also B1 prime. Now measure O1 prime, E prime and transferring it once I have marked O prime, C prime, E prime and in the base I have marked O1 prime, C prime, E1 prime. Join these longer edges and also mark the axis. This completes the required front view in the second position. If you clearly observe, none of the base edges or corner is touching horizontal plane. From the top face corner D prime, the pentagonal prism is freely suspended. Now take the projection vertically downwards and also from horizontal. If I do that, I'll get this completes taking projection from vertically downwards and also from horizontal. Now marking the corners of the top face, I'll get B1, C1, D1 and E1, and the axis is O and O1. If you clearly observe, the prism is inverted. We are getting top face towards left and bottom face towards right. Now in the top view, observer will be here. In order to avoid confusion in marking the invisible edges, first mark the boundary of this prism. So if I mark the boundary of this prism, I'll get E to A, A to B, B to C, C to C1, C1 to D1, D1 to E1 and finally E1 to E. So this completes marking of the boundary of this prism. Now to the observer in the top view, the farthest corner is B1 prime, A1 prime. So therefore all the edges emerging from B1 prime and A1 prime are invisible except they come on the boundary of this prism. So the edges emerging from B1 prime, A1 prime are B1 to B, A1 to A. So since it is coming inside, I can mark B1 to B as invisible and also A1 to A as invisible. And next edge is B1 to A1. B1 to A1 is also coming inside, I can mark it as invisible. And also in the base we have B1 to C and E1 to A. That is B1 to C and E1 to A. So all these are coming inside the prism. So therefore mark all these edges as invisible edges. So I repeat, the edges moving from the farthest corners to the observer are B1 to B, A1 to A, and we have B1 to A1. So in the base, if I observe, we have a line between B1 to C1 and E1 to A1. So all these edges are coming inside the boundary. So mark all these edges as invisible. So if I do that, I'll get E1 to A1. This completes marking of the invisible edges. Now mark the visible edges. In the top face, we have AB, C, D, then E, and again A. In the top face, we have A1, B1, C1, D1, E1. Now, connecting the longer edges E1 to E, A1 to A, D1 to D, B1 to B, C1 to C. Also, mark the axis O1 to O. Since D2 O1 is overlapping on the axis, show only for the remaining part. This completes the required diagram in the top view of the second position. Now, the question is clearly stating that the axis appears to be inclined to VP at 45 degrees. So therefore, incline O1 to O at an angle of 45 degrees to vertical plane. In order to do that, first construct a line at an angle of 45 degrees, mark O1 to O. If you clearly observe, O1 to O, the original length is 50 mm. But if I measure here, it is reduced. So therefore, he has given us the beta angle. Also, show the distance of CG from the base, which I have missed. The distance of CG from the base is 25 mm. Because for rectangle, CG will be at a distance of h by 2. Using protractor, first you mark 45 degree, draw a line. On this 45 degree line, you mark the axis, that is O1 to O. It is better to mark D1 to O directly. So thereby, I have transferred D1, D and O. Also mark O1. Now, using compass, I measured D1 to E1. Keeping at D1, I have drawn an arc. Similarly, measuring D1 to E1, keeping at D, I intersect that arc. Similarly, measuring D1 to C1, I have drawn an arc. Measuring D to C1, keeping at D, I intersect that arc. So thereby, I have transferred E1 and C1. Similarly, you do for A1 and B1. Keeping at D, you measure the distance of A1. So keeping at D, you transfer that by drawing an arc. Now, keeping at O1, you measure A1. Now, keeping at O1, you intersect this. Thereby, I have transferred A1. So similarly, you measure O1 to B1. O1 to B1, you draw an arc. Measure D to B1, you intersect this arc. Thereby, I have transferred E1, C1, B1, and A1. Now, no need to draw arcs for transferring A, B, C, and E, instead of which, just you know the dimensions of these longer edges, just transfer it by drawing parallel lines for these longer edges. That is, measure E1 to E, draw the line E1 to E, measure A1 to A, draw the line A1 to A. Similarly, you measure B1 to B, draw the line B1 to B. Measure A to B, verify it. Thereby, we have drawn A, B, E. Similarly, you draw C1 to C. I have transferred corner C also. Once you transfer all the corners, connect these bottom face and top face and take the projection vertically upwards and also from horizontal. If I do that, I'll get, after taking the projection, marking the corners, in the top face, we have D prime, E prime, A prime, B prime, and finally C prime. Similarly, in the bottom face, we'll be getting D1 prime, C1 prime, B1 prime, A1 prime, and finally E1 prime. Also, marking the axis, we have O prime and O1 prime. Mark the axis, mark the boundaries first. If I mark the boundaries, I'll get D prime to E prime, E prime to A prime, A prime to A1 prime, A1 prime to B1 prime, B1 prime to C1 prime, and C1 prime to C prime. Finally, we have C1 prime to D1 prime. So this completes the boundary of the prism. So now, in the front view, observer will be here. So to the observer, the farthest corner is E1, that is E1 prime. So all the lines emerging from E1 prime must be invisible except they come on the boundary of this prism. So edges emerging from E1 prime are E1 to E, E1 to D1, E1 to A1, that is E1 prime to A1 prime, E1 to D1, E1 prime to D1 prime, and E1 to E, E1 prime to E prime. After marking the invisible edges from our concept, all the edges emerging from farthest corner to the observer are invisible except they lie on the boundary of this prism. Now mark the top face which is nearer to the observer, which is completely visible to the observer. The top face is A prime, B prime, B prime to C prime, C prime to D prime, D prime to E prime. Coming for the bottom face, you have A1 to B1, B1 to C1, C1 to D1, and D1 to E1. So now, joining the longer edges A1 to A, B1 to B, C1 to C, and now when I went to join D1 to D, the common lines are crossing over. So therefore, it is clear that D1 to D is invisible. So mark D1 to D as invisible, hence D1 to C1 must be invisible. So finally we have E1 to E. This completes the given problem in which the pentagonal prism is freely suspended from the top face corner D prime, which can be seen here also, and the axis appears to be inclined at an angle of 45 degree to VP. As usual, I've used same color for these two front views, which means that these two are of same dimensions. For these two top views, I use the same color, which means that these two are of same dimensions. That's all from this lecture. Thank you.